Good morning and welcome to worship this third Sunday in the season of Advent here at Grace Evangelical Lutheran Church in Winchester, Virginia. I'm Pastor Jonathan Boynton, and preaching this morning will be Pastor Martha Miller Sims, and on the organ, Mark Lindgren. Let us continue with our worship. Blessed be God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, whose forgiveness is sure and whose steadfast love endures forever. Amen. Amen. Together, let us honestly and humbly confess that we have not lived as God desires. Loving and forgiving God, we confess that we are held captive by sin. In spite of our best efforts, we have gone astray. We have not welcomed the stranger. We have not loved our neighbor. We have not been Christ to one another. Restore us, O God. Wake us up and turn us from our sin. Renew us each day in the light of Christ. Amen. People of God, hear this good news. By God's endless grace, your sins are forgiven, and you are free. Free from all that holds you back, and free to live in the peaceable realm of God. May you be strengthened in God's love, comforted by Christ's peace, and accompanied with the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Thank you. is near. Let every hill and valley, a level road appear. Then greet the King of glory, foretold in sacred story. Hosanna to the Lord, for he fulfills God's word. God's people see him coming, your own eternal King. Palm branches strew before him, spread garments, shout and sing. God's promise will not fail you, no more shall doubt assail you. Hosanna to the Lord, for he fulfills God's word. Then fling the gates wide open to greet your promised King. Your King, yet every nation its tribute to may bring. All lands will bow before him, their voices join your singing. Hosanna to the Lord, for he fulfills God's word. His is no earthly kingdom, it comes from heaven above. His rule is peace and freedom, and justice, truth, and love. So let your praises sounding, for kindness so abounding. Hosanna to the Lord, for he fulfills God's word.
At every beginning, there is a yearning for the one who is coming. O Emmanuel,
wake us up to your coming.
We gather together to expect the unexpected and imagine the unimaginable. O Emmanuel,
wake us up to your coming.
We wait for the day when God will recycle tanks into tractors and transform minefields into soccer fields. O Emmanuel,
wake us up to your coming.
We stay awake by telling stories that offer a glimmer of a future and agitate dormant hope within us. O Emmanuel,
wake us up to your coming.
Jesus, we welcome your presence now with the lighting of these candles, whose flame brings warmth to winter and fills this place with a glow of hope. Amen.
Amen. We praise you, O God, for this Advent log that marks our days of preparation for Christ's Advent. As we light the candles on this log, strengthen our hearts as we await the Lord's coming in glory. Enlighten us with your grace that we may serve our neighbors in need. Grant this through Christ our Lord, whose coming is certain and whose day draws near. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Candles to watch for Messiah. Let the light banish darkness. Lift your heads and lift high the gateway, for the King of Glory. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Stir up the wills of your faithful people, Lord God, and open our ears to the words of your prophets, that anointed by your Spirit, we may testify to your light. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Isaiah. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins, they shall raise up the former devastations, they shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exalt in my God. For he who has clothed me with the garments of salvation, he has covered me with a robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. A reading from 1 Thessalonians. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit. Do not despise the words of prophets, but test everything. Hold fast to what is good. Abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, then were we like those who dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, and our tongue with shouts of joy. Then they said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them.
The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad indeed.
Restore our fortunes, O God, like the watercourses of the Negeb.
Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy.
Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed, will come again with joy, shouldering their sheaves.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the first chapter. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. This is the testimony given by John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord.'" The Gospel of the Lord. We are apparently in for some celestial treats this week. In an article by reporter Alyssa Ross, the most active meteor showers of 2020 has been taking place and will peak tonight and very early tomorrow morning, December 13th and 14th. The Farmer's Almanac has reported that with a clear sky, you can easily spot 50 or more meteors per hour and maybe even up to 100 meteors per hour. They'll take place in the form of the Geminids. According to NASA, Geminids are shooting stars caused by a stream of debris left by the asteroid 3200 Phaethon. When the Earth passes through the trails of dust from this asteroid every December, the Geminids meteor shower can be seen as the dust burns up in Earth's atmosphere, creating meteors. There's a new moon tomorrow, permitting the extra darkness to help with the visibility of the meteor shower. Ross says it will be visible all over the world, and though best seen in the northern hemisphere, there's no need to look in a particular direction to spot these burning specks of dust. Just find a dark spot, she says, a large patch of open sky, and look up. The best time to view fireballs hurtling through the sky will be at the darkest hour, just before dawn. We'll see. I'll be out there. Next week, on December 21st, astronomers are looking forward to seeing a Christmas star caused by the conjunction, the coming together of Jupiter and Saturn. While actually millions of years apart from Earth, they will look like they are connecting. It's called the Christmas star, or the Star of Bethlehem, because of the shining point of light caused by the conjunction. This is the first time this has happened since the Middle Ages, around 800 years ago. This year, in the dark days of COVID-19 and all the other losses and stress layered into this year, we are yearning for light, like the Christmas star, even more than normal. Someday we will look back on the memories of this year and think about the ways we learned to adapt, to cope, and live through it. We may remember our fears, how things changed temporarily and permanently, how we cared for one another, what gave us hope, what was light in the darkness. We light candles on an Advent wreath or log, three today, as a way to remember that Christ is our source of light, our hope. American writer Edith Wharton wrote, "There are two ways of spreading light, to be the candle or the mirror that reflects it. In today's gospel reading, we can think of John the Baptist as a mirror reflecting God's light. Crowds of people were coming to John to be baptized by him. When the religious leaders asked John, "Who are you?" he told them he was not the Messiah. He was not Elijah. Instead, he said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord.'" How often do we hear about someone so willing to point to someone else rather than to themselves? John is unique that way. In humility, he uses his popularity with the crowds, his substantial influence, to point the way to the one who is coming, the Messiah, whose sandals, he says, he is not worthy to untie. John is a mirror to the true light of the world, who came to prepare the way for this one who brings the hope of life. Not hope as wishful thinking, but hope based on the promises of a faithful God who loves the whole creation, every person. No one is left out of this light shower of grace. The other scripture readings today are beacons of light in our darkness. In Isaiah, God promises restoration for God's people as they return to their homeland after living many years in captivity in Babylon. Psalm 126 is a prayer for restoration and a confession of trust in God who sees us and intends healing and life for us and for creation. It is a restoration of life that brings laughter and joy. Those who sowed with tears will reap with songs of joy. The hymn we will sing in a few minutes expresses this hope. In darkest night his coming shall be, when all the world is despairing. As morning light, so quiet and free, so warm and gentle and caring. Then shall the mute break forth in song, the lame shall leap in wonder, the weak be raised above the strong, and weapons be broken asunder. The Today Show has a film clip about commercial fishermen in Montauk, New York, Chuck Morisi and James Foley, who were fishing at sea out of cell phone range before everything was shut down because of the pandemic in New York. When they got back closer to shore and in cell phone range, they found out that all the restaurants and shops had been closed. They said it was like coming back from the moon. They knew locals would have difficulty getting food. They looked at each other and said, "You know, we're New Yorkers, and we're going to do the right thing." So they've been giving away thousands of pounds of fish, the catch of the day, every month. One local said, "And it isn't one fish per person they're giving away. They're giving 5 or 6 fish in a bag on ice." A restaurant owner interviewed said, "The lifeline of Montauk is fishing. It's a small town. There are a lot of elderly people who can't get around, and everybody knows each other. It's nice when everybody works together to bring things to the table." Charles Morisi said, "If we want to keep everything, we want to help everything get back on track, to keep everyone safe, to help America get back on track. Everybody, help your neighbor. Check on your elderly people. We are going to look back on this and see who did the right thing. We love everybody. We try to do the right thing. We're fishermen, just down-to-earth people." There are many different ways to be a mirror in the light, to point to the light and reflect it out into the world, to be witnesses of hope in the promise of God for life fulfilled in the presence of Christ. Loving each other and our neighbors reflects the light, whether it is in donating fish feeding the hungry in other ways, advocating for the oppressed and the neglected, serving in medicine or some other caring vocation, working to provide necessities, teaching children, and serving in countless other ways to help others thrive in a dark time, to share the hope that is within us. Pastor Boynton and I hope all of us will renew efforts to check in on each other this winter. Remember those you normally sit near in the sanctuary and call them. If you have internet, learn how to use Zoom and join us once in a while and help others do the same so we can see each other's faces. We see the face of God in each other's faces. Caring for each other and our neighbors will be even more important after Christmas this time, and to care for others brings light to us as well. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "It is better to light one small candle than to curse the darkness." Let us be a mirror for the light of Christ in the world. Rejoice, rejoice, take heart in the night. Though dark the winter and cheerless, the rising sun shall crown you with light. Be strong and loving and fearless. Love be our song and love our prayer and love our endless story. May God fill every day we share and bring us at last into glory. Amen.
And greet the new morn, for angels herald its dawning. Sing out your joy, for soon he is born. Behold the child of our longing. Come as a baby weak and poor, to bring all hearts together. He opens wide the heavenly door and lives now inside us forever. To us, to all in sorrow and fear, Emmanuel comes us singing. His humble song is quiet and near, yet fills the earth with its ringing. Music to heal the broken soul, and hymns of loving kindness. The thunder of his anthems roll to shatter all hatred and blindness. Darkest night his coming shall be, when all the world is despairing. As morning light, so quiet and free, so warm and gentle and caring. Then shall the mute break forth in song, the lame shall leap in wonder. The weak be raised above the strong, and weapons be broken asunder. Rejoice,
rejoice, rejoice, take heart in the night. Though dark the winter is cheerless, the rising sun shall crown you with light. Be strong and loving and fearless. Love be our song and love our prayer and love our endless story. May God fill every day we share and bring us at last into glory.
God of power and might, shine your radiance and come quickly to this weary world. Hear our prayers for everyone in need. Gracious God, you have entrusted your church with the work of proclaiming good news and word and deed. Strengthen the witness of bishops, pastors, deacons, church musicians, and artists, lay leaders, and all people who contribute their prayers and talents to public worship and ministry. Embed your word in their hearts. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of every living creature, you announce the year of your favor for all of creation. Extend your kindness and relief to endangered animals and plants. Strengthen the human beings who rely on the rhythms of nature to make their living. We pray for people who have been displaced from their homes by fire, flood, earthquake, or storm. Support the work of Lutheran World Relief, Lutheran Disaster Response, and all disaster relief organizations and their recovery efforts. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You plant us in the world as your oaks of righteousness and ask us to care for one another. Be present with the leaders of every nation as they govern. Give them a spirit of righteousness that your goodness and mercy is revealed to all through their actions. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of the powerful and helpless, you clothe us with strength when our spirits are weak and weary. Bestow your spirit upon this congregation and empower us to comfort the people who turn to us in times of need. Make your church a place of refuge and healing. We pray for healing of body, mind, and spirit for all in need, especially Jim, Ellen, Jan, Laura, Alexis, Trent, Morgan, Doris, Chris, Sheila, Karen, John, Fred, Wendy, Mary, Donna, Diane, Jane, Barbara, Polly, Bill, Brian, Sean, Mike, David, Jeff, Sean, Bobby, Linda, Guy, Mary Catherine, Wilma, Chet, Doug, Jay, Tara, Janice, David, Carolyn Robin, Rusty, Carly, Sheila, Sandy, Mike, Pete, Marilee, Jandy, Jim, Michael, Patty, Dorothy, Walker, Valerie, and all who are affected by COVID-19, and all we name now, spoken or silent. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for all who work on the front lines of the pandemic to care for others, even at risk to themselves as medical personnel, first responders, chaplains, and all caregivers. We pray for their protection, courage, and strength, especially Dick, Scott, Lisa, Sheila, Rick, Julie, Dixie, Courtney, Nikki, Patty, Chris, Xavier, Cheryl, Cianne, Eileen, Joe, Patrick, Linda, Sheila, Joe, Christy, Moray, Vicky, Kathy, Steve, Christopher, Krista, Becky, Gail, Deanna, Bill, Shanti, Stephen, Anna, Ron, Becky, Alexis, Jim, and Keith. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. We pray for the men and women of our armed forces, especially those who are away from home for the holidays, and for their families. We commend them to your gracious care and keeping, especially Seth, Ben, Brian, Chip, Stuart, Andrew, Corey, Elizabeth, Ellen, Mitra, Tyler, Christian, Brandon, Ted, Christine, Alex, Danny, Ron, Cassie, Scott, Ben, Frank, and Pastor Nate. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. God of sinners and saints, you offer joy even in the midst of our grief. We are grateful for the beloved, imperfect people whose lives testified to your radiant love, especially Lucy, martyr of the church. Anoint all who mourn with the oil of gladness. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Draw near to us, O God, and receive our prayers for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go forth into the world to serve God with gladness. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render to no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Honor all people. Love and serve God, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. The glad sound, the Savior comes, the Savior promised long. Let every heart prepare a throne, and every voice a song. He comes a prisoner to release, in Satan's bondage held. The gates of brass before him burst, the iron fetters yield. He comes the broken heart to bind, the bleeding soul to cure, and with the treasures of his grace to enrich the humble poor. Our glad hosannas, Prince of Peace, your welcome shall proclaim. And heaven's eternal arches ring with your beloved.